Hello there, my beautiful friends. How are you? Welcome back to Sacred Knowledge Tarot. We are so happy and excited to have each and every one of you here. My wonderful husband, Paul, is joining us tonight for our full moon ritual. We are super excited here. This full moon is going to be absolutely amazing. It's the last full moon to end the year, so we're super excited about that. Now, the full moon is in the sign of Cancer. So this is an emotional moon, sensitive moon, tender moon. And it's asking us all to kind of dig deep and really look within, do some self-reflection and some introspection and allow ourselves to release anything that no longer serves our higher purpose. So we've got a ton of things planned here for you. We're super excited about this. So Paul, is there anything you would like to share with all of our audience here?
Well, since you asked, I was just going to mention that my understanding is the Cancer moon in winter, it's also the cold moon.
That's right.
So it's meant to be this time during emotional Cancer where we let go of the heavy, heavy toil that we've endured during 2023 and try and let go of all the feelings that are built up, the resentments, the traumas, and give yourself space to hibernate and engage in self-care.
Yeah. It's one of those moons, hey? And 2023, for a lot of us, has been a tough year, right?
It's super challenging, but also super... It's been a growth year. It's been a learning year. There's been... It's a year I'm thankful for, but it's come with a heavy emotional toll, let's say. And yeah, I think people have earned the right through all the struggle that they've gone through to let it go, to release it, or at least begin that process.
That's right. And we're again here during the full moon, which gives us another opportunity every month to really release and let go of all of that and start the new year off on a new note, right? So I feel it's going to be really good because we're going to go ahead and get into this. So what we're going to do here, I've got my itinerary, is we're going to start with a breathing exercise just to ground our energy. So what I would like everyone to do that's watching today is to just sit down comfortably, relax, and we're going to do three breaths. Mm-hmm. So we're going to start with the first breath, taking it in deep, then releasing, the second one even deeper, release, and then the third one even deeper, holding it, and then releasing it.
Right.
You ready?
Let's do it.
Ready to go? Okay, let's do it. So take a deep breath in, everyone. And release. Another deep breath in. And release. Last breath, we want to take this in and hold it in as long as we can. Hold it. Hold it and release. All right. How does that feel?
I feel grounded.
Grounded and a little dizzy, right? All right.
Pleasantly dizzy.
Yes.
Yes.
So now that we've grounded ourselves, we're going to start here with three messages from this deck I have. It's called the Sky Tarot Cards or Sky Oracle Card Deck. And this is a collective reading, so it's for all of our signs. And then we're going to do some separate cards for all the zodiac signs, okay? So let's start with these messages and see what we get here.
Cool.
So first one is coming up is fertility. Look at that.
Wow.
Fertility is coming up for those of you that are wanting to grow and expand in your life, whether this is in your family or if you're wanting to give birth to a new idea. And the message on this card, I'm going to have Paul read. He's going to do all the reading for us today.
I like to read. Fertility says, explore creativity, act on inspiration, thought becomes form, manifest your dreams, and free your imagination.
Wow, that's beautiful. I love that.
Ideas are fertile.
Absolutely.
Okay.
So this is wonderful. So these are the messages coming up here, and let's pull a couple more.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to do three of these cards. All right, look at this. How perfect for today's reading is birth, death, and rebirth. So, Paul.
All right, with birth, death, and rebirth. We've got honor natural cycles, balance giving and receiving, respect nature's intelligence, the grand design. You are in rhythm with life, and move your body, dance. That's the cycle. I definitely think this goes with the theme of the Cancer Moon.
And yes.
The release and everything that we're doing.
And just the flow, right?
Yeah.
It's beautiful. All right, next card we're getting is Vitality. Look at this. This is beautiful. So, Paul.
Vitality. Spend time outdoors. Cultivate healthy routines. You are in symbiosis with nature. Connect with the soil and plants. Gain that grounding
yes.
theme. Nurture yourself and others. And remain young at heart, which is good advice.
Isn't that beautiful?
These cards
are just with the flow of the full moon today. These are just in alignment. I love it. I love the imagery on these cards as well. So
it looks like the most interesting man in the world.
Yes, it does.
Ad campaign.
All right. So next we are going to start with some intuitive cards. Because we have the full moon in the sign of Cancer, everyone is highly intuitive. So we are going to pull some cards here. I think three. And Paul's going to go ahead and read the interpretation from the guidebook.
Sounds good to me.
Yes. So I'm going to hold them up when you read them,
okay.
Honey.
Sounds good.
So let's pull a card here. We are starting with the inspiration. And there's an affirmation that is on this card as well that says, I allow inspiration to fill me so I can inspire others. How beautiful. So I'll just hold this up.
All right. Do you want to read both sections here?
Yes.
Okay. The first section is the art of the matter. It says, the inspiration gazes lovingly at her most treasured possession, the lamp of truth. Passed on to her by the sage who was her teacher and role model. She stands atop a mountain so that her many devoted followers can see her clearly. She did not start out to have any followers at all, but her words, her deeds, and her ability to radiate calmness have produced in her an invaluable quality that is an attractive beacon equal to the light of the lamp of truth, bringing to her those who need to share the energy of her sagacious lineage. The teachings of this revered wise woman have empowered the inspiration to overcome her inertia, her fear of failure, and her fear of success as well. Filled with the love for her venerable mentor, she has been able to persevere despite being confronted by formidable challenges. She's been able to avoid many confrontations with damaged and ignorant people and the traitorous betrayals by people close to her. Were it not for her ability to draw upon the lessons learned from others, she would have been forced to experience these painful lessons herself. The inspiration stands holding a slender spear but without a shield. The leaf-adorned shields in the borders symbolize that the overwhelming power of nature is all the shield she needs. Her simple sandals enable her to feel the ground she walks upon because she does not want to be isolated from reality. The curtains above and around her in the border remind us that life is a show, and how we act and appear to others is a show that can and will be learned from, whether we like it or not. The inspiration has accepted her role model status with her followers and has dedicated the rest of her life to influencing them with her words and, more importantly, her actions. Her very being has merged with this mantle that she has taken up, and it is now second nature to her to inspire in others. That some call goosebumps, but what she calls truth bumps. Such powerful inspiration is one of the most accurate indicators that you're in the presence of truth and importance. So pay attention. The other section says the heart of the matter. So we're all called upon to be influencers now. The powers bestowed upon each of us by technology in general and social media in particular include that of leading by being a good example. Not by haranguing or diminishing others. Just as children must discover and learn how their actions affect others, adults in the 21st century must always be aware of how their words, deeds, and examples either inspire or conspire against those they interact with. So we must, of course, be ourselves and not custom tailor our words and actions to pander to the whims of others and the fads of the day. We must be the change we want to see in others. Therefore, there's no other way to have influence over anyone with strongly felt beliefs.
Wow.
That's the inspiration.
That is inspiration. That was beautiful and powerful.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, my goodness. All right. This is why I don't read, because it has a lot of big words that sometimes I mispronounce.
I was getting challenged, but I like it. I like the challenge.
All right. So we've got next up is the Worrier.
All right.
All right. So this card has an affirmation, which is, I can handle whatever life brings me. These are going to be the themes for all of us this coming year, everyone.
I can handle whatever life brings to me. The art of the matter. A woman walks somberly downhill with a faraway look in her eyes. She might as well be somewhere else, for her worried mind is so preoccupied with the present difficulty that she's unaware of what is actually going on around her. The grandness of the cosmos, the magical shooting stars, and the music of the spheres have all but disappeared for her. All her being is concentrated in her head, which gives off a powerful aura of colored light. The two flowers that lie at her feet are symbolic of the solutions that are right in front of her. However, her attention is on what is wrong, and she looks as though she does not see the flowers and will soon be tripped by them, possibly hurting herself. She carries a box, a symbol of all the hurtful words that might have been spoken in criticism to her. She holds the lid down tight to keep them from emerging at this difficult time. However, it is almost impossible for her to carry this burden and deal with the present difficulty, for her self-confidence has been shaken, and her worries make her too weak to turn around and go back to confront her situation. In the distance stands her stone castle, seemingly perfect and impervious to any threat or outside force. However, the effects of perfectionism have breached the castle walls and wreaked havoc on the lives of the people dwelling within them, as surely as an enemy army. She's been driven from the accustomed security of her home by the sudden appearance of criticism, whose goal is destructive and not constructive. The opal moon that hovers strangely over the castle is a reminder that stone can imprison beauty as well as protect it. It requires patience and delicacy to extract the opal from its stone matrix and fashion it into a precious jewel. Perhaps someone will be moved by her disappearance to look skyward and see this message from on high. The lesson must be learned that peace begins where expectations end. You do not make anyone better by hurting them. And this says, the heart of the matter says, worry is the result of feeling that things are not working out the way they should be. Our attachment to things having to work out a certain way, along with our expectations, causes us to be critical as a way of getting things to be how we expect them to be. Analyzing a situation is an important step in making things better. However, anxiety holds us rigidly in place, preventing us from growing, particularly when we yearn to know the perfect plan or the outcome of plans and actions before they've even reached fruition. So the unknown is always with us and must be embraced if we would live a full life. So at its core, worry is a natural desire to protect you from pain by anticipating problems. However, you are also being practical and logical when you let your successes transform your life, not your failures, real or imagined. Power can be gained by focusing on what has already been accomplished.
Wow, I love that one.
There's some lengthy explanations in here, but it's very full-bodied.
Yes, okay, so let's pull one more, and then we're going to pull some surrender cards, okay?
Okay.
So look at this, we are getting the Actor.
The Actor.
So this has an affirmation, which is, I know how to act properly and wisely in this situation.
All right. The art of the matter says, a figure dressed like either a geisha or a male actor in a Japanese play emerges demurely from one of the petals of an opening flower that is like the proscenium of a stage.
See, that would have not gotten those words.
Some $2 words in here. Okay. They fan themselves lightly, more for effect than to provide any cooling breeze. The fan in their hand is mirrored by those in the surrounding border, and they and the floating dragons heighten the theatrical quality of this scene. In the plays of the traditional Japanese theater, it was common for men to play female roles. There's a strong possibility that under their flowing kimono, laboriously coiffed hair, and heavy makeup, that this geisha girl is really a man. If we want to grow as human beings, it is good to look beyond our habitual system of classification based on our cultural conditioning, our expectations, and even our perceptions. Things are often not what they seem. What has motivated the actor to take on the role of geisha? Is it because those values are ones that merit emulation and widespread dissemination through traveling theater companies? Or is it because the actor feels that the subservient, docile role of the geisha has outlived its centuries of existence and now needs to be held up to public scrutiny? For centuries, theater has inspired and altered ideas of fashion, morals, and politics. Many ancient customs and traditions, good and bad, have withered and died as a result of being illuminated by the intensity of stage lighting. Ideas that could not be stopped by force were often stopped by ridicule or just general understanding. The role of the geisha is the symbol of courtesans and people of all sexes whose lives and livelihoods depend on cultivating the attention and favor of powerful individuals. The role of the actor is played by all of us at some time, but none of us plays it more than those in politics. In China, you could tell a courtier's rank by the number of claws on the dragon that adorned the court clothes, his court clothes. Only the emperor could wear a dragon with 5 claws, and those who hover around the actor have 3, the middle of the spectrum. The life of the courtesan was spent trying to stay in the middle of the powerful forces swirling around the one whose favor was cultivated. There is no such thing as either an actor or a politician without good intuition, a skill that they have consciously cultivated. And the heart of the matter says, it's time to become aware of the politics of your situation. Life is a game, and games have rules. Sometimes appearances are very important, and style is as important as substance. Acting was one of the 3 holy arts of ancient India because an actor imitates the divine spirit when a character is brought to life to play a particular part in a drama. Furthermore, the ancient sages knew a powerful technique for achieving goals that is only now becoming known again, the technique of acting as if the desired goal has been attained. Is a key of law of attraction, mm-hmm. right? Exactly. Sometimes you should act, and most importantly, feel as if things are the way you would like them to be. This will alert and inform your powerful subconscious mind as to how you would like things to be, and your mind will then immediately begin using your intuition to guide you to that goal. You may then begin to see that things start moving in that direction as if by magic, and it may also become clear to you that you need to readjust your priorities in your life.
Wow. That was amazing. I love that card. Holy moly. That was beautiful. All right. So now that we've done that, we're going to go ahead and pull some surrender cards. So if you have a pen and paper handy, we're actually going to write down what it is that we want to release out of our lives. So I'm going to pull a few cards here and see what we get. And then we're going to go ahead and do this exercise together. All right. So let's see what we get here. All right. Surrender to silence, everyone. Surrender to silence. So I'll read the message on these cards here. In quiet meditation or contemplation, let go and enter the stillness within. Silence can heal and replenish you. So look at that. Surrender to silence, everyone. So let's pull another card and see what else we get here. I love these. Really enjoy these cards. Surrender denial. So surrender denial. Let's read this card. Accept people and situations exactly as they are without denying the difficulties. Then you can see things clearly and make the best decisions. So look at that.
Really getting a theme of like introspection and like we're all getting a big reality check.
Absolutely.
At the end of a difficult year, it's like you have to take stock of reality and go, okay, what should I do the same? What could I do differently? And you want to go forward with eyes unclouded. So
that's
it's like
right.
Letting go. Yeah, it's going to be really important to
very
have
important.
That clear introspection.
It's so interesting how the cards align with...
Thematically, yeah. The theme of everything is very...
It's beautiful. It's right in there. All right, so surrender your fear of intimacy. So look at that. Mm-hmm. How perfect of a card to receive today with the full moon being in the sign of Cancer. So let me read this to you. You are ready to let love in, compassionately identify and begin to release any patterns that stop you from opening your heart. So look at that.
I really think that intimacy is at the core, it's trust, but that intimacy is not just about intimacy with another, but also with yourself.
Yes.
Trusting yourself. If you made mistakes this year or you have regrets from this year, you might be like, what am I doing? I'm not even sure about myself. I don't know if I can trust myself. You have to find that way to remake that connection and surrender to your fear of intimacy with yourself and allowing yourself to trust yourself. Because just because you made mistakes doesn't mean you're a bad person. You can learn from everything that's going on.
That's right. Thank you, honey. All right, next we're getting surrender your desire to control people. This is a big one for some, right? So surrender your desire to control people. Being over-controlling can sabotage relationships. To more effectively achieve your goals, back off, regroup, and give the situation some breathing room. So look at that. Powerful.
Just, it ties in with the introspection.
It's all tied in so well. That's like, oh my goodness. All right, so let's do one more, and then we're going to go ahead into the readings for all the signs.
Sounds good.
Look at this. Surrender to creativity. So we just had a card from the intuition deck about creativity. Let your imagination soar, everyone. Stay open to all creative ideas about how to pursue a dream or solve a problem.
Wow. I feel like that's the gift at the end of the introspection of letting go of the desire to control others. Is finally, it's like all these blockages, all these emotional blockages get released and the creativity just flows.
Right in. And I feel a lot of times the things that we hold on to, that weight, it's almost like a block, right? And
when you
release that flow of energy comes through, and it's so beautiful when that happens.
And we don't always realize those blocks are there unless we start doing that introspection, unless we start asking ourselves those questions. And you can only get to asking yourself honest questions if you have that intimacy with yourself, if you have that trust to not be in denial, right? And ask yourself the hard questions to get to the hard answers, which then get you to the truth and what you actually want to be doing. So this is great. I really feel there's a through line thread through all these cards.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
All right. So whenever we all are ready here, I would like everyone to write down what it is that you want to release at this time. And take your time to do this. Once we're done, we're going to go ahead and tear these up. Okay?
Okay.
All right. So let's get going here, everyone. No, I'm kidding. I'm rushing everyone here.
Sorry, I got so much to release.
No, you take your time, honey. And everyone, take your time. You can also breathe through this as you're writing things down. And you know what you can also do is do this every single night if you're able to do that. A releasing journal. Gratitude journal, releasing journal. Anything that you have picked up throughout the day, it's a good to actually release it before you go to bed at night. So you're not carrying that weight while you sleep and bring it into the next day. Right? That's a big one. So what we're going
to
do is we're going to tear this up now. We're going to release this into the universe. So tear it up, everyone. We're going to release this. The universe will take care of everything for us, okay? So let's release it and let's just chuck these things out of here. All right, let's make sure you don't have anything
in
your head.
Yeah, I had
some
in my hair last time.
There was some stuff on his head, so.
For like half the reading, it was great.
Yeah.
I was just like,
and I can't see because he's so tall. All right.
Okay.
So next we are going into all the signs here. So what we're going to do is we're going to start with a message that you want to carry around with you into the new year. Okay. This is the Enchanted Forest Oracle deck. We're going to pull this card first. Then I'm going to pull a card from this Oracle deck. It's called the Oracle of Mystical Moments. I'm going to read you the interpretation from the guidebook. They're short and sweet. But I feel these are going to be for every single zodiac sign. And you know what? I always find that just because they have a name tied to it, like a zodiac sign, doesn't mean that they're just for that sign, mm-hmm. right? They're messages for everyone.
There's a universality to the yes. messages. It just might hone in. You might have more resonance if you're under that sign, but it doesn't mean it's not resonant.
Exactly. Then we're going to pull a healing card for each sign as well. And then an animal spirit. So I love the animal spirit cards. And then we're going to close off each reading with an angel number. Okay?
Cool.
So I'm going to have Paul do this part. So we're going to start with the sign of Aries.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Yes.
Shuffle?
Yes. You get to shuffle and you get to pull it today.
Oh, my goodness.
And I'll do this one after.
This is a lot of responsibility. Okay.
So the sign of Aries, everyone.
Cut that in half.
Oh, and I wanted to say it's Capricorn season, so happy birthday, all my beautiful Capricorn friends. My husband's a Capricorn,
that's
everyone,
me,
so
Capricorn.
Yes.
Yes, next month's my birthday.
Yes.
All right, here we go. You ready?
Yes.
We are drawing the spirit of love.
Aries, look at that, the spirit of love.
Would you like to read this, my dear?
Sure, yeah. All right, so don't search for true love, Aries, for it will find you if you just hold on to who you are. The world already loves your essence, so don't change it for anyone. All right, so the spirit of love. Embrace the message on this card. All right, so next, we are going to pull one of these cards. And you know what? I'll have you read this, honey.
Okay.
All right. So what is it that my beautiful Aries friends need to hear from this card deck today? Listen. Listen is coming up here. So I love these cards. The visuals are absolutely beautiful.
Mm-hmm. Listen, Aries. Mindfulness, sensitivity, empathy. This young woman with closed eyes and a knowing smile is rooted in the earth. Her hair has transformed into the roots of the plants above her. You can tell the woman is aware of her surroundings. She is connected to the voice of nature. She can listen to the growing plants beneath the ground. She's an integral part of her world. She understands the sorrows and worries of the environment. She also knows the songs of nature's pleasures. Listen.
Beautiful. I love this. So listen, Aries. All right, let's pull a healing card here for you as well. Now, these cards have numbers and cute little animals on them.
They are pretty cute.
Yeah. And, you know, you might find that these animals and numbers might follow you around for the next little while. So anytime they do, come back to this message here. So cherish the softness of your heart. And it's a lot about your heart.
Yes.
Emotions, right? That's all about the Cancer sign, the full moon in Cancer, water, emotions, everything. It's so beautiful. So look at this beautiful dog. So if you've been seeing any kind of dogs, if you have a pet dog, this is your confirmation here.
And if you've been wounded enough this year to have hardened your heart, just as a defensive mechanism, totally understandable, let this little puppy melt your heart a little bit and soften it, because you know, it's good to protect yourself, but not at the expense of your ability to feel.
That's right.
And, you know, cherish the softness of your heart.
Yes. Now, this comes with the number 11 on the card. So perhaps you're seeing the number 11 around you right now. Anytime you are, I want you to come back to the message of this card, which is see your sensitivity as a gift. Allow your heart to remain open and love freely. There's an affirmation on this card, which is, it is safe for me to be vulnerable. All right, so look at that. All right, we are now going to pull an animal card, an animal spirit card. And my wonderful husband, he's so good at reading.
I like to enunciate.
Yes. So we're going to get him to do that. All right, Aries. Have any of you been seeing animals or insects in your life right now? We are getting nightingale spirit. Love is all around. Look at this theme of love.
There's a lot of love in the air.
A lot of love in the air,
Aries. Make sure you direct some of it your own way.
Yes.
Love is all around, the nightingale spirit. The oracle message says, in the darkness of night, nightingale spirit sings her song of love and hope. A harbinger of dawn to remind you that the sun will rise again soon. You are so loved, and the illumination song of the nightingale spirit calls you to a new level of self-awareness and connection with the light. Yes, there is shadow and darkness, but love and prosperity do exist everywhere, even in the seeming emptiness of space, darkness, and a starless night. Hearken to the message, letting the music of the nightingale's song remind you that love is all around. Feel it and trust in tomorrow's light, renewing your ability to recognize that the spaces that appear empty are filled with love and abundance. Illumination will happen soon. Should I read the protection
message? Yes, I think we're going to read the protection message for all these cards as well.
The protection message says, the darker the skies, the more it seems the dawn will never appear. But Nightingale Spirit is here to remind you that the sun will shine again. You will soon feel the love and notice the abundance that surrounds you. Sing now. Put on some music or simply sing in that empty space, for finding the light within and giving it voice will give rise to hope and help you begin to hear the call of another who, like you, was beginning to fear the light would never come. Bring the light into the darkness with love from within. Give it voice and know that daybreak will be here soon.
Wow, I love that. Now, this card also comes with the number 41. This could be a number of significance for some of you. Those of you that are looking for timing, the month of April and January are going to be significant. Also, 4 to 1 days, 4 to 1 weeks, and 4 to 1 months. Okay, so a nightingale spirit, and let's pull
angel number.
An angel number for you. So some of you have been seeing angel numbers. This is going to give you your confirmation and guidance today, and you can also use this as an affirmation. All right, so look at this. 111.
Triple one.
I love this. You, my friends, are creative. I'm going to have Paul read the message on this card.
All right. Triple one. Aries, it says, angels are ready to fully support you in this endeavor so that you can co-create with the universe a life that you love.
That's I love that.
You are
creative, everyone. So look at that. Next, we are on to Taurus.
All right.
Taurus. All right. Hello, my beautiful Taurus friends. How are you all out there? So let's pull, we're going to actually pull the Enchanted Forest Oracle first.
Okay.
I'm going to have you do that.
Okay, here we go.
And
shuffle this. Enchanted.
We're putting the cards everywhere. So it's like, what was the order that I was in again?
I'm sure by the third or fourth sign we'll have it totally nailed.
Yes.
Since this is so spontaneous. Okay, here we go. We are getting, you are doing enough. Right now is the time to balance everything you dream of with the actions required to succeed. Be gentle.
All right, so
you are doing better than you know.
Look at that, Taurus. Okay. All right, now we're going to pull a card from the Oracle of Mystical Moments here. So I'm going to give that to you.
Oh, my.
He gets to do all the hard parts. No, I'm kidding.
This is fun for me.
All right, my dear friend. So look at that, my dear friend. I don't know if any of you have seen deer recently in your life, but this is showing up for you, Taurus.
What number was it?
That was number 47.
Okay. 47. Mm-hmm. My dear friend. Lifelong friendship, dependability, and solidarity. If you recall the card, The Journey, you may recognize a similar scene here with a woman riding a deer, but this time both the woman and the deer are much older. Time has passed and the two are still companions. They've seen many seasons together, many sunny joys and even cold sorrows. Their wisdom has grown like the graceful antlers that the woman holds for comfort. The deer supports her and she returns a loving touch to her dear friend.
Perfect. Yeah, there's another card that looks similar to this in the deck, but it has a different meaning. So that's what it's, yeah. So, my dear friend, Taurus.
That's cool.
We're now going to pull a healing card for you as well. So, perhaps you're seeing this little animal that is on this card or the numbers on this card as well. So, what is that my beautiful Taurus friends need to hear today? So, you already know. Taurus, look at that, the number one coming up here for you. So perhaps you've been seeing the number one. This could be a number of significance. The message on this card, and look at this, we've got a little owl. So I don't know if any of you have seen an owl in your life. This is your confirmation. If you are seeing one, the number ones or an owl, I want you to come back to this message, which is the answers you're looking for are already inside of you. Trust your inner knowing here. Taurus, the affirmation on this card is, it is safe for me to trust my inner compass. So you already know, Taurus.
I like it.
Right? It's so nice. Yeah, it does. Intuition is high right now for everyone. Mm-hmm. All right, so we're going to now pull an animal spirit card. Some of you have been seeing animals or insects in your life. This is going to give you your confirmation and guidance today. So we are getting for Taurus, snake spirit. Time to heal, number 55.
Alrighty, 55.
So some of you have been seeing the number 55. This could be a number of significance for you. Those of you that are looking for timing, 5 days, 5 weeks, 5 months, also May being a significant month for some of you. So
May the 5th?
Yeah.
Snake spirit, time to heal. The oracle message says, all of us need healing at times. And when snake spirit appears, it's time to repair, renew, and replenish yourself and your vulnerable heart. Self-care and maintenance work are needed so that your vitality can arise. Give yourself the space to nourish your own well-being. Vulnerability is necessary for friendships and partnerships to work, which means all of us will have tender emotions at times. So be gentle with yourself and others now. Shed the past and step into a new way of being, for vitality is rising within you. This might be a good time to honor the work that you've done to heal, grow, and repair any damage within you, within those you care about, and within your community. Celebrate together how far all of you have come in your healing journey and all that you've created. Unburden yourself of anything that no longer supports wellness, prosperity, positive relationships, and well-being, and open the door for more healing to occur. And the protection message says, no matter how much you may have lost or how you have been disappointed, you are called by snake spirit to shed the past and practice radical self-acceptance now. Only by forgiving yourself can you move on, regardless of whether anyone else is ready for healing. So when your tender new skin first becomes exposed, you may feel uncomfortable, but remember to love yourself and remain vulnerable anyway. You have been weak, but now you are becoming strong and developing wisdom, and you will do better in the future. Snake spirit reminds you that hearts can be so easily wounded. Apologies and amendments go a long way. Self-forgiveness for your role in what happened can help you heal. So remember, it's the one who's been wounded who often has the greatest power to help others heal.
That's beautiful. Shedding the old skin, right? So, sorry, we're on to our angel number.
Yes.
So I'm gonna have you pull this card, Paul.
Very
how's
well.
That?
All right, that's our shuffling music. Here we go. Angel message says, number 13, I am confident.
Look at that. You are confident, Taurus.
And the message says, you are a conscientious worker with a knack for coming up with creative ideas and turning them into something real. An optimistic but practical outlook keeps you determined and on track as you work steadily towards your goals.
Look at that. You are confident. So embrace that. All right. We are now on to the sign of Gemini.
Gemini.
Gemini right here in the house. Gemini sun and rising. Yay. All right. Geminis, how are you all doing today? We're going to pull this Enchanted Forest Oracle deck to see what message you need to carry around this year. Spark of life. Look at that. Mm-hmm. Spark of life, Gemini. Let's read this message to you here. Don't sink into hopelessness and despair, for in your lives a spark of life that is undefeated and unbeatable. You can overcome anything your destiny depends on, so own that. Own the spark of your life.
Nice.
All right.
I love it.
All right. Next, we are going to pull the Oracle of Mystical Moments. Do you have the guide?
Yes, I sure do.
You got them hidden
in my lower shelf here. My book, mini bookshelf.
All right, so let's see what we get here for Gemini. Treasured memories.
All right.
Number 18 here. Look at this, Gemini. Treasured memories.
Treasured memories, we're talking memories, nostalgia, and recognition. We see a woman sitting calmly in the grass. She looks forward to somewhere we don't know while her mind is drifting in the past. With both hands, she is holding a floating balloon filled with clouds. These clouds are old memories she wants to keep and treasure. Our past experiences don't define us. Oops. We can't live the life that we had long ago, but the past does shape us, and remembrances of loved ones and joyful times can help us to be our best selves today.
Oh my goodness, that's beautiful. I love this. So, treasured memories. All right, next we're going to pull a healing message for you, Gemini. So let's see what spirit guides would like you to know here with this healing message. Again, this comes with a cute little animal and some numbers. So anytime you see them, I want you to remember this message here. Call for support, Gemini. Look at that, call for support. This has the number 49 on the card. So this could be a number of significance, right? The message on this card is you don't have to do this all on your own. The help you need is there. Simply ask for it and let yourself receive. Mm-hmm. Now, the affirmation on this card is, it is safe for me to ask for support. And look at this. It's got some beautiful foxes. I feel there's a little duck here as well. And if you're seeing these animals, I want you to come back to the message on this card. All right. For those of you looking for timing, we've got April or September as some significant months. 4 to 9 days, 4 to 9 weeks, 4 to 9 months. All right. So I'm going to go ahead and pull this, honey, and you're going to read that. All right. So Gemini, see what animal spirit you received today. So those of you that have been seeing animals or insects in your life, this is going to give you your confirmation and guidance today. So we are getting sandpiper spirit. Be playful. We've got the number 51 on this card. This could be a number of significance for some of you. And May and January being months for you to be more playful, right?
Yes. Sandpiper spirit. Be playful. The oracle message says, sandpipers are like cute little clowns, poking their beaks into the sand before darting off to chase the waves. The appearance of a sandpiper spirit is a sign that now is a time to engage in playfulness. Whatever tasks you have before you, perform them with a lightness of being. Explore the familiar, discovering the new in the old. Who knows what treasures await you when you let yourself laugh and have fun? Sandpiper spirit's happy and curious nature can help you to feel rejuvenated as you remember your ability to run and fly and dance playfully. The protection message says, when your heart is heavy and life seems to weigh you down, Sandpiper Spirit's message is to lighten your burden by finding joy and humor in the everyday. Become like a playful child, filled with curiosity and wonder, and soon you will feel your own spirit lift. A few minutes or hours of fun-filled delight is exactly what you need now. So enjoy the ridiculousness of life and be willing to just jump in. Let your inner goof out to express itself with abandon.
I love that. I feel that we're sometimes really playful and childish sometimes.
We have to be, because life is serious enough. Like, and none of us get out alive, so we might as well enjoy how silly and ridiculous it can be, especially the tragic parts of life. Those are often the most ridiculous. So it's like, you know, gallows humor might be dark, but it's a way we cope with the darkness of life, is to bring the brightness of our laughter.
Exactly. And look at this. So Gemini, we're going to pull an angel number, which has kind of fallen out here. So let's see here.
We are getting number 4. I am stable.
You Geminis are stable. So look at that. I don't know if you've been seeing the number 4 anywhere, but this is your message here.
And it says, you bring stability and rationality to any situation. You are the rock, and your hard work and perseverance make you a dependable friend, partner, and colleague. You are stable.
You are stable, Gemini. All right. We are now on to Cancer. So how are you, my beautiful Cancer friends? So the moon is in the sign of Cancer. Mm-hmm. So let's see what we get here for you today. So this message you want to carry around with you, Cancer, you decide is the message for you. Wow, look at that, you decide. And what it says on this card is, when you give of yourself freely, you expand your energy. If you only give to get, it will feel like a burden or drain. Be genuine, give from your heart. So look at that. What a beautiful card. I love the imagery on these cards. They're so magical.
It's gorgeous.
Yeah, wow. So look at that. All right, I'll take that back. All right, so let's pull a card from the Mystical Moments. Is that the name of the deck? I keep forgetting.
Yeah,
Oracle of Mystical Moments. All right, there's another deck. I think it's Tarot of Mystical Moments as well that I have here.
There's a lot of overlap in the names, but they all look wildly different.
Yes.
Yeah.
So Cancer, we are getting today Lorelei, number 31.
Okay.
Lorelei for you today. So
Lorelei symbolizes power, responsibility, fate, and grace. A mermaid sits on a rock and gazes towards the ocean. A small ship floats nearby, connected with her through a rope. She has the power to decide the destiny of this ship and the fate of the crew. With a flick of her wrist, she could toss the ship against the shore, or she could let it continue its journey. What will the mermaid decide to do? She has suffered great loss in her own life. Will she continue the cycle of pain, or will she allow healing and grace to calm the waters?
Wow.
That's a good one.
That's a really good one. That is, yep, right on par with everything that we're doing today.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So now I'm going to pull a healing card for you as well, Cancer. So this comes with a cute little animal on the card and some numbers. When you see these anywhere in your life, I want you to come back to this message. So heartfelt gratitude, and we've got a bunch of leaves on this card in the shape of a heart. Mm. So this is going to be very powerful for some of you. And this card has the number 17, so this could be a number of significance. 17 days, 17 weeks, 17 months, also January and July being significant months for you. So the message on this card is celebrate the things that bring you joy when you feel gratitude in your heart. You attract more things to be grateful for. Mm. And the affirmation on this card is, I give thanks for the things that fill my heart with joy. So look at that. What a beautiful message.
Gorgeous.
I love this. Yes. All right, we're now going to pull an animal spirit card for you as well. So some of you have been seeing animals or insects in your life. This is going to give you your confirmation and a guidance today. All right, so let's see what we get here for you today, Cancer. We are getting Panther Spirit, Reclaim Your Power. And we have the number 44 on this card. So perhaps some of you have been seeing the number 44 in your life. Now, the number, if you're looking for timing, 4 days, 4 weeks, 4 months, and April being a significant month for you, especially reclaiming your power or around power. So Panther Spirit.
Reclaim your power. The oracle message says, it takes courage to face challenges. And right now, Panther Spirit is here to say that you are braver than you think. Now is the time to take a risk and step into a different aspect of your being. Speak as you have never spoken before. Act as you've always dreamed that you might have the courage to act. And love fearlessly and fully, expecting to feel the adrenaline rush as you're initiated into a new, braver, bolder self. Panther Spirit says, the time for dreaming about what you want to do is giving way to your first courageous act towards reclaiming your Panther Spirit and power. Your new identity may feel strange at first, but you have what it takes and your soul wants this. Be bold. The protection message says, are you feeling shaky because you've made a bold move and have not yet seen confirmation that everything is going to work out? Or is it fear holding you back? Are you afraid to act until all risk of failure has been removed? Because the moment when there's no risk whatsoever will never come. So follow the urging of your Panther Spirit within and look your fear in the eye. Have you ever heard the famous line, the only thing we have to fear is fear itself? Well, stare down your fear and it will retreat and make way for your courage to fill you from head to toe. Perhaps you're afraid you can't trust the power that's rising within you, and you fear the qualities you will find within when you look deeply at why you resist the challenge before you. Every part of you, no matter how dark it may seem, has a light quality. So be bold and face it. Own the light and make peace with your shadow. Spirit trusts you, so be brave and trust yourself.
Powerful. I love that for you, Cancer. So look at that. All right. So I'm just going to actually shuffle this in here somewhere so it's not... All right, let's pull an angel number and see what we get here for you, Cancer. Some of you haven't seen angel numbers. This is going to give you your confirmation and guidance today. You can also use this as an affirmation. So,
may I get you? Yep. Okey-doke. You are getting number 24. I am generous.
So you, Cancer, are generous.
And it says, you have a heart of gold and are very skilled at maintaining balanced, stable relationships. You are loyal to your loved ones and are able to be the nurturer, protector, and provider all at once.
If you've been seeing the number 24, this is your confirmation. Also, the number 6, 2 plus 4 is 6 in numerology. That's the nurturer, the caregiver. So it's tying in really well with that card here. So next, we are on to Leo. All right, hi, Leo. Beautiful Leo friends, how are you? We're going to pull one card here from the Enchanted Forest Oracle deck. This is the message that you want to carry around with you right now. Forge a new path. Mm. Oh my goodness, I love this owl on this card. I don't know if any of you have been seeing owls, hearing them anywhere on the internet, maybe images. This is your message here today. When you make new choices, you create new results. Let go of old patterns and embrace the power of possibility. You are fully supported here, Leo. So look at that. Anytime you see an owl, remember this message. Okay, so next we are going to pull an oracle card for you from the Mystical Moments here and see what we get here. And Paul's going to read the interpretation from the guidebook. All right, so Leo, Night Ride. 46. We've got owls and an elephant. Look at that. The owl keeps coming up here for you, Leo.
Interesting. Night Ride. Protector. Wonder in the night. Big brother. Friendship. An elephant transports two owls on his back, a mother with her young bird child. Protectively, she has folded her wing over the young owl's head. The elephant rides through the night, blowing stars up into the sky through his trunk. Connected with magic and wonder, the elephant is a protector, a strong shoulder to lean on in all times. Even during dark times, you can feel safe and secure behind him. Beside him.
Beside him.
Yes.
So look at that. What a beautiful card. What a beautiful message here. We're now going to pull a healing card for you as well. So again, there's cute little animals on these cards with some numbers. Anytime you see them, I want you to come back to this card's message. So we are getting embrace your individuality. Now, I'm really bad with my, is that a hedgehog with my little animals?
That or
is
looks, that a porcupine? Yeah, no, it looks like a hedgehog.
Hedgehog,
it's,
so
it's small.
It's hedgehog. A cute little hedgehog. Remember when I first met Paul? You had a hedgehog in your apartment that you, I think your brother was pet sitting. Do you remember that?
That's like 5 years ago.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
So the number 6 is on this card. If you've been seeing the number 6, this could be a number of importance. The number 6 in numerology, again, is a caregiver, nurturer number. 6 days, 6 weeks, 6 months, and June being a very significant month for some of you. So the message on this card is just be yourself, Leo. You are beautiful as you are. The world needs you and your special gifts and talents. And the affirmation on this card is, I am lovable just the way that I am.
I love it.
Yeah, this is beautiful. Mm-hmm. I love this too. All right, let's just put that into the deck here and shuffle. We're now going to pull an animal spirit card for you. And Paul's going to read the oracle and protection message for you today. All right. Let's see what we get here for Leo. All right, we are getting stag spirit. Ooh. Take the lead. The number 58 is on this card. This could be a number of significance for some of you. Also, 5 to 8 days, 5 to 8 weeks, 5 to 8 months, May and August being important months. So I don't know if any of you have seen a stag or any feathers around you. Mm. This is coming through here for you.
It says, take the lead. Oracle message reads, whether or not you have set your intention to lead, you may have found yourself suddenly called to step up to the forefront of your life. Stag spirit is a reminder that now is a time to heed the call to be sure, strong, and compassionate. Others will look to you, and you will have it within you to see through the eyes of the stag spirit and walk with confidence as you take on the responsibilities that are yours now and model integrity in all that you do and in all your relationships. So be willing to see the best in others so that your compassionate heart keeps you on the right path. Stag spirit wants you to know that your responsibilities now are to yourself, too. For you are learning and developing new skills. The best in you is coming into view as you step forward with strength, knowing that spirit supports you as you compassionately take the lead. You're a model for transformation now, sharing your experience, your strength, and your hope with others so that they may grow and discover their best selves as well. What a gift you are. Stay humble and authentic and walk your talk, for this is how a wise leader leads. And the protection message says, others may not be as far along as you are on the journey, but when stag spirit appears in the protection position, you're called to be compassionate and patient as you find yourself leading the way. When others struggle to follow you, they may be unsure that you can be trusted, challenging you to be kind and strong, challenging your value and questioning your worth. Know that your spirit has put you in this place at this time for a purpose and will not abandon you when you need help with your new responsibilities. Or perhaps you're actually uncomfortable leading, maybe temporarily trapped by your small self and therefore promoting yourself too strongly, afraid that others might see weakness or imperfection in you. Let go of your fears and let stag spirit remind you that you have what it takes to lead wisely and ethically if you practice self-honesty and listen to others who wish to support you.
That is a very strong message. Wow. All right. We're going to pull an angel card for you as well. So some of you have been seeing angel numbers or repeating numbers in your life. This is going to give you your confirmation and guidance today. So there you go, honey.
We've got number 22. Ooh. I am aligned.
So if you've been seeing the number 22 in your life, know that you are aligned, Leo.
It says you are in possession of incredible creative powers, and it is assured that you can achieve anything you wish.
You definitely can. That's amazing. All right, so we are on to the sign of Virgo. Hello, Virgo. How are you today? Thank you so much for being here. We're going to start here with the Enchanted Forest Oracle message. This message I want you to carry around with you, okay? So we're getting perseverance. Mm. Perseverance here for you. And this looks like a little cute creature. Could be a hedgehog covered in plants. So the message on this card for you, Virgo, is you have the power within yourself to conquer any challenge and come out stronger on the other side. Trust in your resilience and your ability to persevere.
It's like a little elfin creature.
Yeah. It's cute, though.
Yeah.
It would scare me if I actually saw it.
It's like a creature from the Dark Crystal, that movie.
All right. And it has like little fireflies as well. Yeah. So this could be a sign for some of you who are seeing fireflies. Mm. All right. So I'm going to pull an oracle card from the Mystical Moments for you. And we're going to have Paul read that.
Sounds good.
All right. So we are getting... My dear friend. Did we already pull this card?
We did pull my dear friend before, yeah.
So number 47.
Similar theme.
I think Taurus?
Might have been Taurus.
Yeah. It could have been Taurus. Now there's another card that's similar to this that's going to be mentioned in the book.
Yep.
So those of you that don't have this oracle deck, you might not understand what that other card is. It's a different message.
So the themes of my dear friend are lifelong friendship, dependability, and solidarity. It says if you recall the card The Journey, which is also in this deck, you may recognize a similar scene here with a woman riding a deer. But this time, both the woman and the deer are much older. Time has passed, and the two are still companions. They've seen many seasons together, many sunny joys, and even cold sorrows. Their wisdom has grown, like the graceful antlers that the woman holds for comfort. The deer supports her, and she returns a loving touch to her dear friend.
I love this. So I don't know if any of you have seen a deer in your life recently. This is your message.
We've been seeing deers all year.
I know. We've got videos on my Instagram page, also YouTube shorts mm-hmm. of deers in our yard, and we fed them.
You fed them by hand. That was amazing.
All right, so Virgo, we're going to pull a healing message for you. These come with cute little animals and some numbers. So anytime you see these, I want you to remember the message of this card. Remember to rest. We've got a little fox on this. So this has the number 17. This could be a number of significance for you. Those of you looking for timing, 17 days, 17 weeks, 17 months, also January and July being months of significance for you. You don't need to spend every minute of your life in action. Give your body the rest and care it needs. And what a perfect time now to do that. The affirmation on this card is, it is safe for me to take a break. So look at that. Wow. So if you're seeing a fox, this is your sign to rest. Okay, so we're going to pull an animal spirit card for you as well. And Paul's going to read you the oracle message and the protection message from the guidebook. All right, so Virgo, let's see what we get here for you. Some of you have been seeing animals and insects in your life. This is going to give you your confirmation and guidance today. So we're getting koi fish spirit. There is always enough, everyone. The number 36 is on this card. And again, this could be a number of significance for some of you. March and June being important months again. And, you know, those of you looking for timing, 3 to 6 days, 3 to 6 weeks, 3 to 6 months.
Koi fish, there is always enough. Oracle message says, the koi fish, who grows big within a small pond, reminds us that within each of us is the potential for prosperity. The law of abundance ensures that prosperity is our natural state, so regardless of temporary outer conditions, you can call in prosperity and magnetically attract the opportunities and abundance you need. The message of the koi fish spirit is to begin to generate wealth within with deliberate intention, no matter how small your pond may seem, and appreciate abundance whenever you see it. Outer conditions will come to reflect your inner prosperity, so begin to become the self who is comfortable with wealth in all forms. Even if, at the moment, it feels as if riches are not yours, they soon will be. Start to envision the plenty that spirit wants you to experience, knowing that the moment you begin to commit to conscious and deliberate co-creating, spirit will joyfully start bringing you what you need. You have so much to offer and so... You have so much to offer and so much of value to express to the world. So in your little pond, there's much you can create and much you can attract. Do not underestimate what you have and who you are. For koi fish spirit wants you to know that you are exquisite, loved, and deeply cherished. Trust that outer conditions are changing to reflect that truth. And the protection message says, are you feeling a sense of scarcity, afraid you will not have enough and not be enough to meet the challenges you face? Whatever your outer conditions, they are temporary, and reflecting that what was set forth in the past. Koi fish spirit is your ally in changing those conditions by transforming your inner beliefs about scarcity and plenty. Perhaps you've suffered a loss or you're afraid that you soon will, or you've been scraping by and feeling that there are simply no opportunities available for you to better your circumstances. Koi fish asks you to find prosperity within you by connecting to spirit through spiritual practices. Spirit wants to remind you that your natural state is one of abundance. So remember all that you have to offer so that you can generate your own opportunities, love relationships, and even more. Even if you feel you have little to give right now, find it within you to give to someone else, even if it's just a few encouraging words, a smile, or a helping hand. Your action will remind you that you have more than it appears, more gifts, more strength, more wisdom, more abundance. As you give to others, your own sense of prosperity grows and your outer conditions begin to shift in an alchemical reaction. Prosperity and love are yours to receive, experience, and enjoy. So believe it.
Wow, that's beautiful. So koi fish. So I don't know if any of you have seen a koi fish. If you own a koi fish, this is your message today. So I'm going to pull an angel number for you as well. So some of you have been seeing angel numbers in your life, repeating numbers. This is going to give you your confirmation and guidance today. And you can also use this as an affirmation. So we are getting the number 10. I am ingenious. You are ingenious, Virgo. So if you've been seeing the number 10, this is your confirmation today. This is your message. You have great leadership skills. Your mind is sharp and allows you to dream up ingenious ideas and organize all the details, then direct others how to carry things out. There's that leadership quality again, right?
Wow.
So in numerology, 1 + 0 = 1.
Yep.
That's that leadership number in numerology, fresh starts, beginnings, all of that, right? So we are on to the sign of Libra. So hello, our beautiful Libra friends. How are you today? So we're going to start here with the Enchanted Forest Oracle deck. This is a message that I would like you to carry around throughout this year. So the pause is the shift. Okay, so the pause is the shift. And look at this. We have a beautiful moon and a deer in this card.
My dear friend.
It's like the blue of the cold moon.
Oh, wow.
Right?
Yeah.
It looks like the cold moon, what we're experiencing right now. So the message on this card is your past is now behind you. All you desire is right in front of you. Pause to reconnect with your power and follow the pull of your destiny.
Wow.
That's a powerful message here for you. So we're going to pull an oracle message for you as well from the Oracle of Mystical Moments. And Paul is going to read us the interpretation from the guidebook. All right, so let's see what we get here for you, Libra. Elixir of Life, number 15. Elixir of Life, everyone.
It says healing, consolidation, reinvigoration, and truth. A woman is leaning towards a deep red rose. She faces the flower with her eyes closed, concentrating on the lush bloom. She is receiving the sweet scent of nature and the energy of life. The wind rustles her hair, whispering the truths of the universe into her ears. She can hear her own breath mingling with the wind. Sitting quietly in nature by a stream or in a garden will help still our wandering mind and heal a troubled heart.
Wow. I like that. That's beautiful. I love the imagery on this card as well, right? So we're going to go ahead, Libra, and pull a healing message for you as well. These cards come with cute little animals and numbers. So anytime you see them, I want you to remember the message of this card. All right. So we are getting here. You are free to choose. And that's a little rhinoceros,
yeah,
right?
Rhinoceros.
A cute little baby rhinoceros. So I don't know if any of you have seen a rhinoceros lately, but this is your confirmation here. This comes with the number 55. So perhaps some of you are seeing the number 55 in your life. Those of you that are looking for timing, 5 days, 5 weeks, 5 months, also May being a significant month for you. The message on this card is don't worry about what others want for you. You get to choose your own path. And the affirmation on this card is I am free to decide what's best for me.
Cool.
All right. So look at that.
Lucky.
Beautiful message. We're going to go ahead and pull an animal spirit for you as well. Paul is going to go ahead and read the guidebook, the oracle, and the protection message for you today. All right. Look at this. We got a card that just jumped out.
Wow.
We've got a cow spirit.
Yes.
The miracles are endless, and the number 15. So again, this could be a number of significance for you, Libra. 15 days, 15 weeks, 15 months, January and May being important months for you.
All right. Cow spirit, the miracles are endless. The oracle message says you are at a beautiful point in your life today, for your needs are being met effortlessly and in so many ways. Fully embrace this truth by focusing on all that you have right now, including your positive relationships that sustain you, the work you are proud to do to contribute to the world, and the activities that inspire you and nourish your soul. Cow spirit nudges you to pay attention because this is the perfect time to focus on the choices, actions, and behaviors that you know feed your soul and bring your heart contentment. Now is also the time when you will see many of your projects and commitments that were set in motion in the past begin to yield valuable gifts that will bring you joy and love and sustain you for a long time to come. Stay positive and share your well-being with others. The more you share, the more you will manifest, so be generous. Cow spirit promises you will never run out of miracles. The protection message says, Cow Spirit asks you to pay attention to how you nourish your mind, body, and spirit, because right now, you're wobbling around like a newborn calf on its unsteady legs. Perhaps you've been spending too much time distracting yourself on the internet, or obsessing over a relationship, or choosing to eat food that's not so healthy. Whatever it is, you're being nudged to assess how you are looking after your needs. Remember, the universe has a way of reflecting back to you events and conditions that match how you treat yourself. Cow Spirit reminds you that the universe wants to give you the very best, but needs you to do your part to participate and nourish your well-being. Heed her message, and everything will shift in your favor.
Look at that. That's Cow Spirit for you. All right, so Libra, let's pull an angel number for you. Some of you have been seeing angel numbers or repeating numbers in your life. This is going to give you your confirmation and guidance today. You can also use this as an affirmation. All right, so we're getting the number 15. I am wise. You are wise, Libra. So if you've been seeing the number 15, this is your message today. Your love for others is powerful, and you're able to spread your gift of support far and wide. Your curious and social nature brings you in contact with a variety of people, all who would benefit from your warm, heartfelt words of wisdom. So look at that. That's beautiful. So there it is. We are now moving on to the sign of Scorpio. Hello, Scorpio. How are you? We're so happy to have all of you here today. So we're going to start with an Enchanted Forest Oracle card. What I would like you to do is carry this message around with you into the new year. What do you want, Scorpio? This is your message here. What is it that you want here, my friends? Look at this card. I'm going to read it to you. So if you react negatively to the success and joy of others, it's a sign that you want more for yourself. Don't hold yourself back. Expand your comfort zone. All right, so it means getting out of your comfort zone to expand it, right? So this is your message here. I want you to carry this around, especially if you're seeing any kind of, what are these flowers called again? They're like umbrella flowers or little dumplings?
Orchids?
No. If you see anything like this. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and pull an oracle message for you as well. Paul's going to read the guidebook. And let's see what we get here for you, Scorpio.
Oracle of Mystical Moments.
Oracle of Mystical Moments. And we are getting Touch the Sky. So look at that, Scorpio. Touch the Sky, the number 32. It has crows, lots of crows in this image. So you might be seeing some crows in your life.
Touch the Sky themes are lost in thoughts, isolation, and sanctuary. A young girl with long braids looks down to earth from up in the skies. The small bird on her shoulder keeps her company in her cloud sanctuary. She is holding one of her braids like a lifeline, as if she is expecting somebody to climb up to her. Sometimes, we are so overwhelmed by our feelings and sensations, we escape into a condition of withdrawal and separation. It is hard for other people to follow us there unless we give them a sign that they are welcome.
Ooh, look at that. So touch the sky, Scorpio. All right, so we're going to go ahead and pull a healing card for you as well, a message. So again, this has little animals on it and some numbers. So anytime you see them, I want you to remember this message, Scorpio. So let's see here what we get. You don't need others to understand you. And what is that?
Is that a honey badger?
Is that a honey badger? I think so. Is the honey badger. Oh my gosh. Have any of you seen that honey badger video on the internet?
The unstoppable honey badger.
The unstoppable honey badger. Oh my goodness. It is so cute, but vicious.
Yeah.
Right? So the message on this card here, well, actually, it has a number 25. So this could be a number of importance for some of you. February and May being important months. Also, those of you looking for timing, 2 to 5 days, 2 to 5 weeks, 2 to 5 months. The message on this card is release self-doubt and hesitation. Only you can know and choose your path. So I feel this is aligning with that Enchanted Forest card as well. So the affirmation on this card is, I stand firm in my own truth and knowing. All right, so that is your message here. So we're going to go ahead and pull an animal spirit card for you as well. So some of you have been seeing animals or insects in your life. This is going to give you your confirmation and guidance. Paul's going to go ahead and read the oracle and protection message from the guidebook. All right, so let's see what we get. We are getting ant spirit. Time ant. To collaborate. Look at this. Putting together the puzzle pieces with an army of a team.
All right.
Right? So number one, again, January could be a month of importance. 1 day, 1 week, 1 month, and even 1 year for some of you, okay?
Ant spirit, time to collaborate. Oracle message says, when ant spirit comes to visit, it's to celebrate the benefits of working in a partnership with others as part of a community or tribe. Spirit reminds you that to build your dream, you need to work with others. Accept help and trust in your most important partnership, the one you have with spirit. Your intentions will come to fruition if you remain awake and focused on co-creating your reality with others and with spirit. So remember that the world around you can easily seduce you if you don't have some sort of practice or discipline like meditation to keep you on track as you build the life you desire. Connecting with others and having accountability partners can be very helpful, as it's unlikely that everyone will fall asleep at the same time. The other message that Ant Spirit holds is that you are now at an auspicious time to ask for help and receive it. Whether you need help assembling a team, finding a new tribe, or requesting assistance from others who are there for you, everything is working to support you right now. And the protection message says, do you really believe that you have to do everything yourself? Do you believe that somehow any help you get will be disappointing or not good enough? Perhaps it's time to address your issues of control and bias towards the negative. It doesn't matter where or why you came to be pessimistic or mistrustful. The fact that Ant Spirit is showing up now is a sign that you have an opportunity to heal and to relearn to trust that others will show up for you in a genuine way. Ant Spirit wants you to remember that your expectations and limiting beliefs are a vibrational offering that draws in the opposite of what you desire. Spirit wants to help you and will help send collaborative partners your way, but it's time to see the universe as conscious and connected, loving and helpful. And you must participate in this activity of co-creation, because creating reality is not just about dreaming. So if you're feeling orphaned from community, reach out and communicate. If you feel vulnerable, know that being present in your vulnerability can help you draw in someone who wants to assist you. Trust in your partnership with spirit, and your outer conditions will start to reflect that. Then you will see the miracles waiting for you, including partners who appear ready to lend a hand.
Wow, that's beautiful. So that is your animal spirit card. And next we're going to go ahead and pull an angel number for you as well, Scorpio. So any of you seeing any kind of angel numbers, repeating numbers, this is going to give you your confirmation and guidance today. You can also use this as an affirmation. So look at this. We are getting 999. So if you've been seeing the number nines around, you know that you are unique, Scorpio. So let's read this message. The number nine is a humanitarian number in numerology, right? So thank the past for your lessons and leave it where it belongs, so you can make the best of the life that is still waiting to be fulfilled by only you, Scorpio. So look at that. That is your message. All right, we are now on to Sagittarius. Wow. Sagittarius, how are you, my friends? We're so happy to have you all here today. So I'm going to go ahead and pull an Enchanted Forest Oracle message. I want you to carry this around with you into the new year. Inner strength is your card today. So look at this, tapping into your inner strength. So if you've been seeing any kind of fairies, sparkles, fireflies, the message here is, don't lose yourself in things you can't change. Focus on the things you can change. Attitude, mindset, and energy. You've got everything that you need. So look at that.
Great card.
Right?
That's.
I feel like this is for everyone.
Yeah, absolutely.
All these messages are really for everyone, right? So there you have it. We are going to pull an oracle card from the Oracle of Mystical Moments. And Paul is going to go ahead and read the message from the guidebook. All right. So, Rose Garden, number nine here. So, look at this. Scorpio. And again, we've got, we've got a butterfly. Yeah. We've got a lot of leaves and this
even her hair's caterpillar. Kind of
shaped, I believe. A caterpillar. Look at that.
Rose Garden, sensitivity, awareness of nature, integrated whole, and strength. Look at this beautiful woman who is transformed into a flower. She holds a red blooming rose to the place where her heart belongs. Her hair has become a leaf blown by the wind. She's a part of nature and grows stronger with her every gentle touch and loving gesture. She is not alone. Her friends, the caterpillar and butterfly, are here to visit. Thorns threaten to prick her, but she's not scared. A rose is beautiful and strong because of its thorn, not in spite of them.
Lovely. I love that. All right. I'm going to now pull a healing message for you as well, Sagittarius. So let's see what we get here. Now, these cards come with cute little animals. They also have numbers on them. So anytime you see them, I want you to come back to this message of these numbers or these animals. So believe in the power of light. And this is a cute little baby lion or tiger.
Baby tiger. Yeah.
Baby tiger. So look at that. A baby tiger. I don't know if any of you have seen one recently. The number on this card is 20. This could be a number of significance for some of you. Those of you that are looking for timing, I'm getting 20 days, 20 weeks, 20 months, and February being an important month for some of you. So the message on this card is trust in the higher plan. Your path is protected. Nothing can harm you. And the affirmation on this card is I am divinely protected. So look at that.
It does kind of look like Simba from Lion King. Maybe it is a little lion. I don't know.
I don't know. You tell us, everyone.
Yeah.
What does this look like to you?
Baby lion or baby tiger?
Yeah. All right. So next we are going to pull an animal spirit card. Paul is going to read the oracle and protection message from the guidebook here. So any of you seeing animals or insects in your life, this is going to give you your confirmation and guidance today. All right, so we are getting White Raven Spirit, Trust in the Magic. Yeah, number 66. So I don't know if any of you have seen a White Raven. I feel even Black Raven counts. Okay, so again, number 66 being a number of significance. Perhaps you're seeing the number sixes. June being an important month, 6 days, 6 weeks, six months. Trust in the Magic.
All right, Trust in the Magic. Oracle message says, nothing in the universe is random, for the intricate web of co-creation weaves together all events and has done so since the beginning of time. Coincidences have meaning, and the White Raven Spirit appears to remind you to pay attention to these synchronicities so that you might recognize the patterns. Even the winds dance in a pattern, participating in the magic of Spirit's plan for all. Align with the highest good and intentions, and you will come to see that White Raven is guiding you, an ally to you and a messenger from Spirit. Align with the light, and you will start to recognize that all is working together harmoniously in ways the eye can't always see and the mind can't always comprehend. The universe is conspiring on your behalf right now, drawing you to the light and bringing you the magic and miracles that are your birthright. Now is the time to trust in the magic of the world that is everywhere and in all things. Pay attention to how things come together as if by magic, and you will see the great hand of Spirit, the hand of the Great Spirit, arranging things in your favor. And the protection message says, are you being distracted by the illusion of a chaotic universe? Deep in your heart, you know the world is full of magic, and White Raven has appeared to remind you that the ways of the world can cause spiritual amnesia. Stay awake and alert, for Spirit wants you to enjoy all the miracles around you. And remember, the evidence of divine order can be seen everywhere. Ask for a sign, and it shall be yours. Synchronicities happen all the time. So if you're in a time of challenge and feeling cynical, all you need to ask is for a reminder. White Raven will appear to reassure you that all of this is leading to something better, for magic is in the wind.
It's always in the wind. It's always
the name
I find.
Of the wind.
All right, Sagittarius, I'm going to go ahead and pull an angel card for you. Some of you have been seeing angel numbers or repeating numbers in your life. This is going to give you your confirmation and guidance today. You can also use this as an affirmation. So we are getting the number 19. I am a pioneer. You, my friends, are a pioneer. So if you've been seeing the number 19 anywhere in your life, this is your confirmation and message. Independence and self-sufficiency are necessities to you. You are extremely capable in life and in work and aren't afraid to take big risks to achieve the life that you desire. So look at that. That's beautiful. I love that. All right. I think we've got three more signs left, and then we're going to go ahead and light a candle. We're going to set an intention, and we're going to pull the strings of abundance in.
Sounds good.
We are now on to the sign of Capricorn. You, he's a Capricorn.
Hello, me.
So all of you Capricorns out there, hello, my friends. Thank you so much for being here. We're going to go ahead and start with the Enchanted Forest Oracle message for you. So I want you to carry this around with you. So you are safe, Capricorn. You are safe, honey. Feeling. All right. So I'm going to read you the message on this card. Be grateful for closed doors, obstacles, and detours. Have faith that the divine mind will give you past and... Sorry, let me read that again. Mm-hmm. Have faith that the divine mind will guide you past and around everything that you don't, that doesn't deserve you. So look at this beautiful card. It has these beautiful white flowers. I don't know if these are orchids, but they're beautiful. Mm. Oh my goodness. So know that you are safe, my friends. And this says actually it's a moonflower spirit. So look
That's
at
cool.
that.
I've never
I love
seen that,
that.
Before.
So that is your Enchanted Forest message. I'm going to go ahead and pull an oracle card from the Oracle of Mystical Moments. And Paul is going to read the message from the guidebook for you today. So we are getting listen.
It's the one from
Look
the
at that. It's from the cover. Listen. And that's number 6.
Listen. Mindfulness, sensitivity, empathy. This young woman with closed eyes and a knowing smile is rooted in the earth. Her hair has transformed into the roots of the plants above her. You can tell the woman is aware of her surroundings, and she's connected to the voice of nature. She can listen to the growing plants beneath the ground, and she's an integral part of her world. She understands the sorrows and the worries of the environment, but she also knows the songs of nature's pleasures.
Wow, beautiful.
I need to listen.
You're actually a really good listener, I have to say. Oh my gosh. No complaints there. All right, we're going to go ahead and pull a healing message for you today, Capricorn. So any of you seeing these cute little animals on these cards or these numbers, I want you to come back to this message. So we are getting, keep yourself grounded in the earth. Is that a lemur?
I want to say it's a lemur.
We're not sure what this is.
It's because of the eyes. The eyes
made so you can feel free to share with us what this animal is.
I thought
is
a lemur has like ears that stick up. So I don't know.
I've seen this animal in
platypus maybe?
Yeah. So whatever this animal is, it's Capricorn. If you're seeing this, I want you to remember this message. This also has the number 26 on it. So number 26 could be a number of significance. February and June being important months for us, it's probably a vacation. 2 to 6 days, 2 to 6 weeks, 2 to 6 months. The message on this card is place your feet firm on the ground. Take practical steps to make your dreams happen. The affirmation on this card is, I am safe and grounded in the earth.
Nice.
So look at that. You are safe and grounded in the earth. So look at that. My husband's playing footsies with me right now.
I'm guilty. Okay.
All right. So we're going to pull an animal spirit for you. So those of you that have been seeing animal spirits or insects in your life, this is going to give you your confirmation and guidance today. And Paul is going to read you the oracle and protection message from the guidebook. So we are receiving hawk spirit. Let spirit be your guide, Capricorn. So I don't know if any of you are seeing any hawks around. This is your confirmation. We also have the number 32, which could be a number of significance. March and February, again coming up February, as important dates. 3 to 2 days, 3 to 2 weeks, and 3 to 2 months.
Hawk spirit, let spirit be your guide. The oracle message says, flying high. Above the landscape, the hawk sees both the big picture and the small details, observes the rain and the pond, as well as the cloud. It doesn't miss anything. When hawk spirit arrives, you are called to pay close attention to messages from spirit that can appear anywhere in any form. Listen to your intuition and keep your eyes open for synchronicities, the meaningful coincidences. Again, the hawk spirit asks you not to dismiss the signs that spirit is sending to guide you. Lately, have you been hearing the same word or song or coming across the same symbol here, there, and in the strangest places? Perhaps you hear a song on the radio with just the right lyric pertaining to your query, or you begin to notice uncanny billboards or license plates or other places where repetitive numbers or words show up for you to notice. Pay attention to the animals that appear for you and connect with their symbolism. Spirit wants to communicate and reaches out again and again. When hawk spirit appears, it is a sign to listen.
Whoa. Oh my goodness.
Are you, protection message says, are you noticing red flags? Perhaps saying to yourself, oh, what pretty flags, and giving them no more thought? Hawk Spirit has arrived to tell you to stop and listen to the spirit, listen to the messages from Spirit. Take the time to observe the patterns you're seeing and do not dismiss your intuition, even if the messages you receive are not supported by evidence in the physical world. If it feels illogical to listen right now, listen anyway. Sometimes you might want certain signs and messages to mean what you want them to mean, interpreting through the lens of wishful thinking, a projection of your desire to see things a certain way. Of course, when you do that, you rarely find yourself where you want to be. So take heart. Spirit loves you so much and does not want you to get hurt, but to align with Spirit's plan for your highest good. Listen and follow the signs and check your motives when you're being selective with your hearing.
Wow.
This resonates with me.
So the Hawk Spirit, embrace it. All right, Capricorn, we're going to go ahead and pull an angel number for you. Some of you have been seeing angel numbers or repeating numbers in your life. This is going to give you your confirmation and guidance today. You can also use this as an affirmation. So we're getting the number 24. You, my friends, are generous. So if you've been seeing the number 24, this is your message today that you have a great heart. Sorry, you have a heart of gold and are very skilled at maintaining balanced, stable relationships. You are loyal to your loved ones and are able to be the nurturer, protector, and provider all at once. That you are. So there you have it. We are now on to the sign of Aquarius. Hello, Aquarius. How are you, my friends? We're so happy to have all of you here today. We're going to go ahead and pull an enchanted forest oracle message for you. So what I want you to do with this message is carry it around with you. So we're getting heart path. So look at this beautiful imagery on this card. Heart path. I'm going to read you the message on this card. It's not worth pursuing a path without passion. This road will only lead you to uncertainty and frustration. Follow your heart and you can't go wrong. Mm. So it's time for you to follow your heart here, my friends. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and pull an oracle message from the Oracle of Mystical Moments. Paul here is going to read you the message from the guidebook. All right. Okay, so we are getting my home is my castle. Mm. So look at that, the number 39.
My home is my castle. Experience of life, growth, knowledge, and age. The woman on the card carries a big castle on her shoulders. The castle is solid. It seems like it was growing each year of her life. The castle stands for the woman's soul. Ooh. Inside its enduring walls, she keeps all of her memories, thoughts, knowledge, and feelings. The older the woman gets, the more this fortress of life grows. It keeps her company, defends her against pain, and provides the foundation for her true self to continue its journey.
Wow, I love that. That is beautiful. So we're going to go ahead and pull a healing message for you as well, Aquarius. So again, these have cute little animals on the cards and numbers. So whenever you see them, I want you to come back to the message of this card. So we are getting Weave Your Magic, mm. Aquarius. We got a cute little bunny rabbit. Mm. Oh my goodness, I love little bunnies.
Me too.
I used to chase them around when I was young, trying to capture one so I can keep it as a pet.
They're so quick.
So this has the number 48 on the card. This could be a number of significance. Those of you that are looking for timing, 4 to 8 weeks, 4 to 8 days, 4 to 8 months. Also April and August being significant months for you. So what do you desire, Aquarius? Decide what it is that you want and work your magic to manifest it. The affirmation on this card is, I embrace my innate magical powers. So you are magical. Believe that, Aquarius. All right. So that is your healing message. Now we're going to pull an animal spirit card. Oh my gosh, I'm losing track here
now. We're good.
At the end of this.
Very consistent.
Any of you seeing animals or insects right now, this is going to give you your confirmation and guidance today. So Paul here is going to read you the oracle and protection message from the guidebook. So we are getting Bobcat Spirit. Life is a mystery. And we have the number 8. This is the year that we're coming into, is the year number 8, 2024. And this is a number of power. Now, for some of you, 8 days, 8 weeks, 8 months, August being an important month for you. Okay. So again, life is a mystery.
Life is a mystery. The oracle message for Bobcat Spirit says, the Bobcat moves furtively and mysteriously, and when Bobcat Spirit appears to you, she brings a powerful reminder that not all things in life can be explained or understood through the power of intellect. Trying to figure things out, find logical explanations, or predict what will happen based on reason and facts will not always provide you with the certainty and comfort you seek. So Bobcat asks you to trust in the great mystery and let the secrets of the universe reveal themselves to you through direct experience. Allow your vision to slip into soft focus, and you will see between the lines and observe what has been hidden there all along. Bobcat Spirit helps you know intimately the pulse of the divine in the world. Trust in the wisdom and revelations that come to you, yet know that understanding may not come as you would like it to. What you experience through your heart and your intuition, which comes to you as the voice of your inner knowing, will guide you now as you accept that secrecy is woven into the fabric of existence. No matter what, the appearance of Bobcat Spirit is a sign that you're being called to trust, even when what is revealed does not agree with your need for intellectual certainty. The protection message says, Bobcat Spirit tells you, this is not a time to reveal your deepest, most cherished dreams and desires to others, but rather a time to be quiet and gentle with yourself as truths begin to emerge in your awareness. Self-protection is called for, so be discerning, selective, and even secretive, revealing no more than is necessary. People have a way of imposing their opinions on you, so pay attention to whom you surround yourself with at this time, and be watchful and check your own motives as well as those of others as you keep your secrets to yourself for now rather than expose them to others who may potentially misunderstand your intentions or just may not be supportive. Let your logical mind take a rest as you start to perceive the energy of your environment. Bobcat Spirit wants you to be stealthy and wise and keep your own counsel. Let yourself be a mystery yet to be revealed.
Ooh, I love that message. That's powerful. You know what I'm seeing? Like, as I have this on the camera, I'm seeing like an image coming through of a person.
Mm-hmm.
It's really interesting. So I don't know if there's somebody on the other side that's wanting to come out and speak to you there, Aquarius, but I'm feeling that energy.
Gary Oldman. In that
Gary
image.
Oldman, right?
The actor Gary Oldman, his face.
Could be a person by the name of Gary Oldman.
Yeah, or those an old names. Man.
Or, yeah, Gary and old man. You never know, honey.
You never know, right?
All right, so we're going to go ahead and pull an angel number for you, Aquarius. Some of you have been seeing angel numbers or repeating numbers in your life. This is going to give you your confirmation and guidance today. You could also use this as an affirmation. So we're getting the number 10. I am ingenious. Yes. You, my friends, are ingenious. So if you've been seeing the number 10, this is your confirmation and message today. You have great leadership skills. Your mind is sharp and allows you to dream up ingenious ideas and organize all the details, then direct others how to carry things out. So look at that. That is your message today. So last but not least, we are on to Pisces.
Bye, Aquarius. Hello, Pisces.
Hello, Pisces. How are you, my friends? Thank you so much for being here today. So we're going to start here with an Enchanted Forest Oracle message for you. I want you to carry this message around, okay? So we are getting, you are doing enough. So no, Pisces, you are doing enough. I'm going to read you the message on this card. Right now is the time to balance everything you dream of with the actions required to succeed. Be gentle. You are doing better than you know. So look at that.
That's lovely.
That is a lovely message.
Very reassuring.
And we've got tons of little sparkles and these beautiful flowers, these young little kids running around in the forest. One that's kind of
ethereal.
All right, so we are going to go ahead and pull an oracle message for you from the Oracle of Mystical Moments. Paul here is going to read you the interpretation from the guidebook. So let's see what we get here for you today, Pisces. All right, we are getting to the moon and back.
Ooh.
Number 51. So look at this beautiful imagery. And we have a little bird on her shoulder. And she's holding a bird. Lots of feathers here. So perhaps you're seeing some of the imagery on this card in your life right now.
To the moon and back, desires, wishes, longings. Look at this woman sitting on a swing shaped like the moon. She gazes longingly into the distance as if she would like to be somewhere else. Although her skirt is made out of feathers, she stays seated and does not fly away. This card speaks about strong desires. Sometimes we crave what we don't have. Instead of taking action, we remain passive and let our dreams fall unknown. Let the powerful magic of the moon reveal any unpredictable desires.
So there you have it, Pisces. That is to the moon and back for you.
Interesting message.
I wonder if any of you say that, to the moon and back. I love you to the moon and back. I've heard that a lot.
Yep.
All right, so we're going to pull a healing message for you as well. So some of you have been seeing some of the animals on this card, maybe the numbers. I want you to come back to this healing message anytime you see them. Mm-hmm. See them. So we're getting open yourself up to the present, and this is a little fawn.
Yeah.
So look at that. You got a little fawn on this card. Open yourself up to the present moment, Pisces. And 54 is the number on this card. This could be a number of significance for some of you. May and April being significant months. 5 to 4 days, 5 to 4 weeks, 5 to 4 months. Live in the here and now, Pisces. Receive the gift. Receive the gift this moment holds for you. And the affirmation of this card is, I enjoy my life moment to moment. Hmm. That's beautiful.
Yeah, that's quite beautiful.
All right, next we are going to pull an animal spirit card for you as well. So those of you that have been seeing animals or insects, this is going to give you your confirmation and guidance. And Paul is going to read you the interpretation from the guidebook. It comes with an oracle message and a protection message. And he is going to go ahead and read them both to you. Is that bothering you, honey?
This Not at all. I like the smell out of here. It's
yeah.
great. So
all
fresh.
Right. So we're getting bee spirit.
Ooh, bee.
Number 7, sweet results await you, Pisces. So I don't know if any of you have been seeing bees. This is your confirmation here. And the number 7, the number 7 is tied to the moon, to Cancer, to emotions. It's about self-reflection, introspection, and spirituality. Mm. Those of you looking for timing, 7 days, 7 weeks, 7 months, and July being an important month for you.
Bee spirit, sweet results await. The oracle message says, the bee spirit's message is that sweet rewards are on their way. If you're willing to get your ego out of the way and immerse yourself in the connected energy of all things. Bee spirit knows not to let a sense of being, Bee spirit knows not to let a sense of being a separate self get in the way of a good thing. Spirit is always producing honey. Miracles and magic are everywhere. So when you connect with the great hive, you're vibrating and buzzing in exquisite harmony with all. Bee spirit asks that your focus be on connectivity. Your body, heart, soul, and psyche experience total interconnectedness and a true integration when you self-forget, when you remember that you are part of a greater unified consciousness. So moving from separation into connection, from self-centered limitation to spirit-centered infinite possibility and potential, you become busy as a bee, enjoying the gifts of the bee spirit. Fully in alignment with your highest expression of yourself, your heart opens and creativity rushes through you, seemingly without effort, as you experience that nothing feels like work. Industriousness is driven by enthusiasm and inner motivation, and time seems to fly by quickly as the hive supports you in the making of honey. Do you feel the presence of your helpers in their hidden realms, adding their energy to your creations? Magical results are taking form and will be sweeter than you expect. Bee Spirit wants you to remember that your part in the divine partnership with the conscious universe is being rewarded even if you can't see it yet, and asks that you share your good fortune as there's plenty of honey for all. Be a part of the larger whole, the force that brings forth all that is sweet and delightful. And the protection message says, when Bee Spirit comes as your protector, she asks you to be very honest with yourself. Do you want to taste the sweet honey others have been making, but you believe is unattainable for you? Do you wonder how others ended up with so much magical honey when you seem to have none? Have you bought into the illusion of separation and become convinced that you can't have what others in the hive enjoy? Do you separate from the hive to do it all on your own, or to hoard what honey you have, unwilling to trust that there's plenty of support and plenty of sweetness to go around? If you've been overworking and overdoing and have not given yourself any time to enjoy the sweetness of your life, Bee Spirit is telling you to stop and recharge. Perhaps you're afraid that if you don't get something done, it just won't get done. However, even busy bees need to take a break. And when they do, the honey still gets made. So remind yourself that sweetness is everywhere and available to you always when you need
always. It. Always, yeah. So that is beautiful. I'm going to go ahead and pull an angel card for you as well, Pisces. So some of you have been seeing angel numbers, repeating numbers in your life. This is going to give you your confirmation and guidance today. And you can also use this as an affirmation. So we are getting the number 18. I am kind-hearted. Apologies for the mistake on this card. So if you've been seeing the number 18, this is your confirmation that you are both open-minded and open-hearted, and your ambition is to leave this world better than you found it, Pisces. Ensure that your goals are aligned with the collective need and with the highest good of all. So look at that. That is your message today. So this is everyone's readings. What we're going to do is we are going to light a candle today. So if any of you have candles, it's probably a good time to grab them right now. What we're going to do is set an intention. You don't have to have a candle. You can just use your mind, visualize, and release it into the universe. So we're going to do this together. If you have people around you, you have one candle, that collaborative energy is actually even more powerful, right? So we're going to go ahead. So everyone set an intention right now, and then we're going to go ahead and light this into the universe. This is also for those of you that are wanting to bring light into your life. It's a perfect time to do that because the days are slowly becoming brighter. There's light coming into our lives now. It's that part of the season, right? So we're bringing light into our lives. We're setting our intentions. We're going to go ahead and do this. So we're going to do this together as a couple.
Okay.
All right. All right. So we're going to go ahead and light this. I love gazing into fire just to see kind of what I get sometimes from this. And you know, if you're into breath work, following how the candle, like the fire of the candle, and breathing according to how this kind of flows. I don't know if any of you practice breathing, but this coming year, I feel breathing is going to be a big part of us, especially if you're feeling overwhelmed. Doing some breathing exercises are really going to help. And any of you that are interested in purchasing these candles, my sister-in-law makes them. The description for the link to purchase these candles is in the description box below. So these are handmade, and this is my authentic chai candle here. So we're going to go ahead and put this over here, and we're going to close this off by pulling in strings of abundance, something that I enjoy doing, something that we practice quite a bit here. And it brings in a lot of abundance. And what we're going to do is just imagine the moon. If you're able to see the moon from your home, that's amazing. We are in a closed room here, so we can't see the moon. But you can visualize the moon and imagine strings kind of dropping down from the moon, whatever you want them to look like. I just imagine sparkly strings. And what you can do is just go ahead and pull those strings of abundance in. You can imagine abundance as anything you would like, whether it's money, whether it's happiness, whether it's a new job, if it's positivity, just good things. Pull it all in towards you, everyone. And as you're pulling them in, you want to wrap these strings around you. Wrap them as much as you can. Pull as many as you would like. I like to do this around near my window, as I'm looking outside at the sky, visualizing the moon, bringing them in, wrapping myself all around, and just walking around my home with these strings of abundance. And watch how you experience the magic of the universe work in your life. Also, if you would like to do some sort of a cleansing ritual after this moon ritual is complete, it's basically complete, but you can take a shower and wash away the day. And once you've done that, you can ground yourselves using that water, just imagining that water going down your body, extending from your feet into the ground, right? And after you've done that, I like to do this at night. And what else you can do is write in your journal, release anything that is in your mind into that journal, and also have a separate journal. I know this is a lot of work, but having a gratitude journal and writing down everything that you are grateful for in your day, right? Even if it's something small or big. So that is my message. I don't know if you have a closing message here for everyone today, Paul.
I just think, everything you said about techniques for release, techniques for attracting abundance, techniques for cleansing, and releasing those emotions. A lot of this is visualization in your brain.
Yeah.
These are all symbolic actions that help feed your subconscious, which then percolates into your conscious mind and helps you move forward on all these things that you want to do. So as much as some of these things seem audacious or silly, it's like it's your belief in the ability of the symbolism to provide the result that you want. That's what gives it its power. So just remember that, and you have the ability within yourself to have that strength to attract things, to release things that don't serve you, and to reinvent yourself constantly throughout your life. So take that opportunity during this full moon to release and reinvigorate, and happy holidays.
Happy holidays, everyone. Thank you
hope
so
you had
much
a happy
for
holiday.
Yeah, hope you had happy holidays. That's right. Thank you so much for all of you that are here and have been through this moon ritual, this whole thing with us. Thank you so much. We wouldn't be here if it wasn't for you, and we are very grateful. So thank you so much, everyone.
And thank you for
and thank
everything.
You.
This 2023 has been the most amazing transformative year
oh my
of
gosh,
my life.
Yes.
And it's thanks to your efforts. I think your audience can agree that you have really stepped up throughout the last year and grown so much and provided so much value to so many people, inspiration, mm-hmm. motivation, helping them find answers and guidance. And even your advice, it's just like there's so much warmth and practicality and even vulnerability that you show. And I think that's why you continue to grow and attract more people. And so on behalf of your audience, because I'm in your audience, I watch your videos.
Yes.
Like, thank you so much for everything that you do.
Thank
you so much, honey. And it really means a lot.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I'm so grateful. And I can't wait. We're going to continue doing this and see where it takes us. We're thinking about bringing live events to everyone as well. So I just wanted to throw that out into the universe here because we've got a lot of plans. Paul has also...
We're working on a few things. A few things that are going to be coming out in 2024.
Yeah, so
it's gonna be
lots
exciting.
Of different things. So we're excited. Thank you, everyone. And we wish you all the very, very best.
Bye.